everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You might think the games get more important as we get deeper into the season. Try selling that to this sellout crowd who've been screaming their guts out and ready for kickoff in the SEC. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the head.
Black Warrior River, we're in the fifth largest city in the state of Alabama. Tuscaloosa is the site of today's game. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calorie. Enjoy everything. Alabama is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. He'll return it from the six. He's tackled at the 27. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Fires out to his receiver, and they make the stop right around the 42-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they got to him before he could get back to the line. Georgia State's not only looking to win this one, but they could set some records along the way. I mean, that's secondary to the real work. First of all, you want to win the football game. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 41-yard line. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
They come out in an empty backfield. Caught, open field. And he's tackled at the 45.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Complete, he's got room. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That makes it second and two.
Man left. Four down. Mike 51.
Quick strike and he drops it. It's third down and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. The ball. Got the corner. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. So the ground game picks up another first down.
Well, this really works on a defensive psyche. You can see the guys on defense right now just trying to catch their win. Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now.
And And he's taken down at the 13. It's the ninth play of the drive. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. It's the 11th play of the drive. Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. And for Johnson, that touchdown toss gives him the team's career record in that department.
Here's just another notch in what's been an outstanding career. It's sort of hard to comprehend how good he's been for so long.
And he hits the PAT. It was an 11-play, 74-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Georgia State is lining up to kick this one off. Kirk, today we get to watch one of the great wide receivers in college football. Henry's footwork, his great hands, his speed, he is a dangerous offensive weapon.
No doubt, Brad. He's really one of the most exciting players to watch in college football. He catches everything that's thrown his way and is a legitimate deep threat downfield to make big plays for this offense. He's going to face some double, sometimes even triple team coverage. And I think today, this defense, they might do a decent job of slowing him down, but eventually, he's too dangerous. He's going to make some big plays.
From their own 25-yard line, first down. He's to the 40. And they finally knock him out at the 49. Kirk, you and I have talked to the coaches. We've talked to his teammates. Everybody says this kid's a real deal. We're about ready to find out. From the 49-yard line, it's first down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Brought down at the 41.
That makes it second and 2.
He has some room.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 30. Got an opening. Tackle made around the 18-yard line. Scramble. Now he's going to run and watch out. What a play, and that is first and goal. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
First and goal from the 3. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. They come out in a goal line set. Going to the end zone. Touchdown for the tight end. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He's splits the uprights with the extra point. Alabama ready to kick this one off. Taken from the 10. He's out to the 30. Gets out to about the 31. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 35-yard line. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. We've played one. We get a tie game at 7-7. We're all tied up as we head into quarter number two. He's at the 40, at the 30, and he's finally shoved out at the 25.
That's good for a gain of 32 yards. First down.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Here's a run. Inside the 10. And now he's got room to run. Great looking play by the offense as the halfback took it in for the score.
Here's a play that was well designed and well executed. It can't get much better than that.
He makes the PAT. Georgia State to kick this one off. Tackle made at the 25-yard line.
Well, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. He fights forward to about the 26. It's second and nine. Ball on the 26. After positive yardage.
Third down.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Go, Mike 51, Mike 51. Hey, it's coming up. Hey,
ready. Go, go. Green 90. Green 90.
The ball pops free. Picked up by the defense.
Way to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Georgia State up 7 points. They'll bring him down at the 42. From the 42-yard line, second down.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
That one's incomplete. Johnson's the kind of athlete that you can build your entire offense around. His athleticism, second to none. We'll see if they have an answer for him today. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Gets it. He's in space. And down he goes around the 34-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Fires in a hurry. Interception.
Really nice cover skill shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corners.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Off the right side, doesn't get much. Good tackle. A couple there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
We've got third and 12. Ball on their own 34. Makes the catch and look out. And they make the stop around the 47-yard line. Into the 37. From the 37-yard line, first down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's tackled at the 26. He's under pressure. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
The defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was a big play, and on first down, no less.
From the 12-yard line, it's first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Muhammad gains about 5 yards on the option play. Alabama is going to use their first time out of the half here. This is the ninth play of this drive. And he's immediately tackled. Mullins gained 6 yards on the play, and they'll come away with a first down.
Heads-up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown time. Mullins had high expectations since he was a high schooler, and now it looks like he's every bit as good as suggested. Congratulations to him on his first touchdown. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 64-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
14 apiece. Alabama is ready to kick it away. From the 7. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 36.
always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's knocked out of bounds.
Right around the 46-yard line. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
He wants it all, going long. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Now he's scrambling. Tackle at the 45-yard line.
It's a good job of converting on third down with the running game.
The Panthers taking their first time out of the half.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Back's got it on the quick throw, and he's taken down
right around the 30.
So they gain 6 yards on the play and pick up the first down.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
Throws complete, and he stopped immediately.
That's a 25 on the play. That'll make it second and four.
He's looking for six. And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Under pressure, and he might want it all here, and does.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
And he converts the extra point. Georgia State to kick. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
Henry's emotional impact on this team, I think, is as big as anything else. And now that he's struggling with the technical part of things and just trying to get the offense going, I think it's kind of affecting the rest of the team right now.
Yeah, it does seem to be affecting him individually, just watching him. He seems frustrated. He wants the ball in his hands. He wants to be able to make plays and have a chance to affect the outcome of this game. And right now, the quarterback and the offensive coordinator are not finding ways to get the football in his hands, and he's clearly frustrated about it.
That brings in second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Roger, roger. Mike 51, Mike 51. Here we go, here we go.
Set. Green 88.
There's the strike complete. From the 50, second down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He wants it all. Incomplete.
I'm sure both defensive coordinators will be going back to the drawing board in the locker room at halftime. The Panthers lead 21-14.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Kick slide, get your hands on them, keep them at an angle, keep them off balance. How about the big fellas up front just absolutely stifling the pass rush?
We talk all the time about how defense wins championships and the guys in the trenches. How about the hog mollies up front? I mean, my goodness, that quarterback, he could bake a pie. Feed it to him in the pocket. He had so much time to sit back there, nice, warm, and cozy. Might as well get him a bottle of milk and a blankie back there in the pocket, because he was just sitting back there nice and protected. Anybody can deal in that situation. I've seen Reese Davis deal in that situation.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Butler takes it from the six. They'll bring him down at the 30. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Got an opening. He gets to about the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line, first down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a deep seven. That'll make it second and four.
The ball, and the ball hawking safety scoops it out. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
They're ready to begin another drive. Georgia State is up seven. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down at the 47. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. He's tackled at the 43.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
That's a great tackle at the 30-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the way. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. And they get yardage on that run.
Call the game 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Taken down at the 24. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Strike to his receiver, no good.
First down grab. Tackle made around the 12-yard line.
Robinson makes the tackle at the 12-yard line.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Georgia State is up a score. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over after a loss. This is the 10th play of the drive. Incomplete, almost picked off. It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. Georgia State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. This offense was infected by the turnover bug their last time out. Let's see if they can hold on to the ball here.
The defense, I'm sure, will be aggressive again. They love going for the strip and attacking the football.
And a quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 35.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And he's level at the 46-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. He fights forward to about the 39.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
From the 39-yard line. Second down. They come out in a 5-wide set.
Here I come again. Ready. Wide in.
Caught. Enough for the first down. And they make the stop at the 24-yard line. One more quarter to play, and now they're just trying to hang on. The Panthers with a 10-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Gets it out to the tight end, and he can't hang on.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 24. He's scrambling. They'll make the sack.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
All right, D, let's go. All right, D.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
Let's go.
tackled at the 19-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Well, that's just too bad. They made the stop, but a flag is going to keep the chains moving.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he's tackled after positive yardage. They get about 6 yards on the option to the halfback.
That brings up second and goal.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Touchdown, Crimson Tide.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
Here's the point after to try to cut this to a 3-point game. He makes the PAT. Kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Georgia State has a 3-point lead.
Throws left, the running back's got it, and they got to him before he could get back to the line. 3-yard loss there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 22. Drill at the 26.
That'll make it third and nine.
Catches it, and that's all. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Brown is waiting for the snap. He's tackled at the 49. Alabama's staff know that they've got a guy in a crucial situation that can maybe make the difference in the ball game, but you can't just rely on him alone.
Yeah, you got a real difference maker lined up on the outside. The defense knows that. You know they're going to tilt their defense, the secondary especially, towards him. It's going to open up some opportunities for other wide receivers and maybe even running backs out of the backfield to be able to make plays.
Steps out of bounds, right around the 46-yard line. That'll be a gain of 5.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
From the 46-yard line, second down, just under 2 minutes in the game. Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle around the 36-yard line. Change of quarterback, Kirby. You got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy. Stuffed.
second and 11.
From the 37-yard line, it's second down.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Ready.
And he's taken down at the 31. Inside the 10. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 10-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Stop behind the line. Alabama will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. We have less than a minute to go. Touchdown, and that's going to give them the lead. Late in the fourth quarter now, and with that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. And he tacks on the extra point. Bell, ready to kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26-yard line.
Georgia State still got a chance here. They might come up short, but not for lack of trying.
Well, I've been impressed with this team the entire way. Now we're going to really find out what they're made out of. With the game on the line, late in the ball game, how do you go out and execute?
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. It's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. He's got it with room to run. Brought down at the 41.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That can be just enough time for the quarterback.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 34-yard line.
Hill makes the tackle at the 34-yard line.
Check, check, Disco Raver!
That brings up second and one.
Spikes the ball. Five wide. Makes the first down catch. He's tackled at the 30.
First down.
He guns it. It's over. It's over. Thank you.
They just didn't get the snap off in time. Here's the call. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he hits the PAT. Henry's going to be the first guy to say that this game was his fault. He's just got to get back at practice this week and hope for better things next week.
Yeah, he puts so much pressure on himself. And after this kind of performance, you know he's going to be the first guy back in the meeting room, first guy back in the weight room and out on the practice field to try to put this loss behind him and try to get better.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.